Well, Croc got the Hawks this week. What are we expecting team-wise?
Oh, look, we're probably expecting that, throughout the pre-season, we've been looking at players' loads, and some guys have had pretty heavy pre-seasons and heavy loads, so there could be a couple of changes this week.
Expecting any of the younger guys to get a crack?
Yeah, I think when you say younger guys, some of the newer guys, in saying that, Benny Jacobs has nearly played every game now, and Jordan Gisbert's, Dan Curry's, played in each of the NAB Cup games. So, they're perhaps not babies, not the first years in the system, but they're also new to the club.
Your thoughts on the pre-season so far?
Oh, look, it's been a solid pre-season. I think every club would, get up in front of a camera and say, oh, yeah, it's been a really hard pre-season, hardest we've had, and we've done so much running and extra skill work. But, I think each year it does just step up another level, and, we're no different. The guys have put an enormous amount of work into the pre-season, and, hopefully that's going to hold us in good stead, especially, at the start of the year.
In terms of the NAB Cup, had a loss on Saturday, but obviously pretty happy to get three wins as well.
Yeah, look, it was to get good to get three wins. A couple of tight games in the first try series, so it was good to get over the line in those. Then really oppressive conditions against Gold Coast up in Townsville, so that was a really sapping game for the guys. And then there were some good signs against Geelong down at Simmons Stadium. But, it's still a bit disappointing to lose. It was a prelim for us. We could have been playing in a NAB Cup grand final, which is always, I don't care whether, it's NAB Cup or, obviously home and away is the most important, but it's always nice to sort of be able to put yourself into a situation where you're going to be playing a final. We fell just short, but there were some good signs there still.
Geordie Gisbert's been pretty impressive in the NAB Cup as well. Is he someone you see in line for round one at all?
Yeah, look, he is. First couple of rounds in the NAB Cup, he was he really put his best foot forward. Didn't have such a good game on the weekend down at Geelong. And we've gone through his game and had a look at areas that he can improve on. But he's come in. His attitude's been really, really good and really strong. And, he looks like he's a player who really wants to develop and get better. So that's going to hold him in good stead.
And Dan Curry as well. Must have been pleasing to get a lot of clearances on the weekend. A lot due to his work?
Yeah, well, he got his hand to the footy a lot. We did do well in the clearance area. I think we probably, the dominance that he had in the ruck, we could have done even better from a midfield perspective. But, yeah, look, he's been super impressive. He's really relishing another opportunity. He's obviously gained an enormous amount of confidence going back and playing in the Sandfall last year. So he's come in and been done really well. So again, he's another one who's going to make it a hard decision for us at match committee come around the selection for round one.
And are there any other boys that you're expecting to gain in the midfield this year? Sean Attlee might be one.
Oh, look, that's trained up as a midfielder throughout the pre-season. We also know how damaging he can be off half-back with his run and his penetration. Kieran Harper, again, has done a lot of midfield work, so he gets a feel for bodies in close. And again, we think that he's got some attributes that could really help us in there with his pace and his agility, not dissimilar to a Daniel Wells. Ben Cunnington just has improved again, throughout the pre-season with his clearance work and his midfield work. They're three probably from a midfield perspective that, I've done some really good work throughout the pre-season.